now we got this nice finish on Fail Fail's head. So we're gonna go ahead and try out some new scissors and give her a nice finish. We're also gonna talk through the steps in achieving a nice top knot. It seems to be one of the things that a lot of groomers have a difficult time getting. And I know I did when I first started grooming. I couldn't figure out how to get that shape. I fought with it and fought with it and fought with it until I realized a couple quick tips, and I'm gonna go over those with you. So what we have here are the new Sensei shears, and these are rotating handles, which are supposed to be really a lot better for our hands. I have not used them much, so I'm still kind of experimenting with them myself. But the first cut that we're gonna make, we're gonna comb this all forward, the top knot nice and forward, and I have actually a pair of straight shears in my hand, and I'm gonna make that first cut. And kind of set in my little visor line. It's okay, baby girl. It's okay. Good girl. And like I said, we're just gonna really do the top knot and blend it down into the neck just a little bit. Fail Fail will be used at a different booth later today to do the rest of her, so she'll match. So again, we're just setting in that visor line first. So we'll comb that all forward again. Okay, so the next thing that I would do, normally, obviously, we would work from the back forward and we would have this body all done. So I'm gonna kind of go backwards a little bit and set in a little bit of my neck here, just so I have a line that I know I'm working with. And then I'm gonna follow up over the top of the ear and get that line cut in. Okay, babe. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. That's fine. I'm gonna stand back up. Oh, sweetie. It's all right. And just like a dog in the salon, sometimes we have to work them through it just a little bit. It's okay, sweetie. Up. It's all right. It's okay. Move it back over so you don't fall off. Okay, so we're gonna make another attempt at this. Good girl, Fail Fail. Good girl, good girl, good girl. Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. So this line up over the top of the ear is really important. You want to make sure that you get that nice arch up over the neck and a nice clean line so that you have that definition between the top knot and the ear. And when you bring that line up from the back forward, you're gonna make sure that you're not too narrow at any point. We're gonna flip the ear back and comb this hair down and get a nice clean line from the corner of the eye to the ear opening. And this is something else that you kinda gotta pay close attention to, because a lot of poodles tend to have a bad ear set. The ear should actually be level with the eye, which hers is nice. But a lot of the poodles that we see, the ear is set too high, and they have kind of like a flying ear. And at that, when you notice that there's a conformational fault like that, you want to kind of try and hide it, camouflage that fault a little bit. So you might want to set that line just a little bit differently in order to hide that a little bit. But her ear set is nice, so we're going from that corner of the eye to the ear opening, a straight line across. And a standard poodle, you want to see a little widening at the top knot. So we're kind of angling our shears out just a little bit and bringing that line up. Good girl. Okay. So we're gonna.
The ones of you remaining, just have 5 minutes.
See if we can
scissors down.
Flip her around the other way to get the other side of the dog. Can you turn this way, sweetie? Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. And we're going to do that same exact thing on the other side. I'm going to try and come up behind the ear just a little bit and set in a little of our neck and shoulder lines that we normally would have had done already. It's okay, babe. It's okay. Again, that nice clean line over the ear to set in that separation between ear and top knot is important. On this dog, obviously, we don't have a nice full ear. We have more of like the German style ear, which is awesome and fine. And it's great for dogs who have ear problems. And we do see a lot of those in our salons. So on a dog like that, it may be something that you want to talk to the owner about removing some of the weight from that ear and taking the ear either short, all the way short, like Fail here has, or maybe a tasseled ear like a Bedlington would have. It's kind of a cute ear style on a poodle that we don't get to do a lot of. But both of those would be options to remove some of the weight and open up that ear a little bit so that they can get a little bit more air circulation in there. Again, we're going to flip the ear backwards now that we got that line set in. And comb that down. And from the corner of the eye to the ear opening, again, we're gonna make a nice clean line. And remove any of those little stray hairs that we might have missed when we were trying to get a nice clean line with our clipper blade. Again, my scissor is angled out just a little bit to give her a nice full top knot. And we all have a different style of top knot that we like to do, so this is kind of, you know, the way I like to do mine. But something that I found that really has worked throughout the years for me. Okay, we've got both our lines set on both sides of the head now. So we're gonna bring all of the hair over to my left side here. And I'm gonna grab my curved shears and clean up that line. Again, these are the new Sensei revolving handle shears, which I'm still playing with. Okay, so we're pulling all that hair over to one side, and we're gonna make sure that our line, you can see we have a little bit of hair that's hanging over that nice line that we just scissored. So we're going to go ahead and take that off and kind of roll it into the top of our head. And then we're going to do the same thing on the other side. We're going to comb everything to the opposite side. And you can see we have hair that's hanging over that line again. So we're going to go ahead and take that off. Switching to my curves. And rolling that into the top of the head. It's okay, babe. It's all right. It's okay. It's okay. Okay, so we've taken off all the hair that hangs over our line on both sides. So we're gonna kind of pull it all up and stack it up. And now a trick that I've always found that worked well for me is if you pull the dog's nose down towards the floor and you look at that top knot from the top down, you wanna see a nice oval shape. So obviously here we've got a couple long spots. Our oval shape seems to be off at all four corners. So that's where we're going to kind of focus our attention now, is getting that shape that we need to see from this angle. So I'm going to tighten up this corner here. And this side as well. And you can see that this line over the top of the ear is still a little bulky, so we want to tighten that up as well. And you can see, like I was talking about, that nice oval shape is starting to form now, so we're doing good. I'm just gonna scissor in this back of the neck a little bit. Again, we're leaving the rest of this dog for a demo later in a different booth, but. All right, so I'm pretty content with where we're at there. Now, really, the only thing left is to take a little length off the top of the head. So we're gonna stack it all up, and you can see we're kinda high in the middle, which is an easy fix. So we're just going to go back through with our curves and take off that high spot. Make sure we're kind of rolling everything into the same line that we created. And then you just go back through and just tweak it just a little tiny bit. And that's all there is. Fail Fail's pretty head.